प्रेम से बोलो श्री वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की। अरे वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की, नॉट बिकॉज़ द टॉपिक इज डेथ, वी हैव टू से जय। प्रेम से बोलो श्री वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की। डेथ डिफाइंस लाइफ, डेथ पुट्स लाइफ इनटू पर्सपेक्टिव, डेथ इज अ पंक्चुएशन दैट अलाउज अस टू रिफ्लेक्ट एंड टू रिकैलिब्रेट those measurements that we set, the standards that we set for ourselves while we're here. Dear friends, do you know that after we die, and I'm saying, using the word die and death very loosely at the beginning, that at the time of death, do you know that when the body is pronounced death by the medical doctors, that the fingernails continue to grow? Do you know that? Even when the person is medically pronounced as dead, the fingernails, they grow. Do you know that when we are medically pronounced as dead, the hair on our body, not only on our head, but the hair on our body, that also continues to grow? Spooky, isn't it? Do you know that if I die, I shaved maybe about an hour ago before Mandir, and do you know that if I drop dead now, by tomorrow morning, or after tomorrow, based on how quickly we can arrange funeral, by tomorrow, after tomorrow, before Das brings the body to our home, do you know that they would have to shave me? Because the hair on the body will grow. And sometimes we hear this and we think, oh, what a very interesting scientific fact. Well, it is science. Science has confirmed that the nails will continue to grow, the hair will continue to grow, not infinitely, but for a defined period. And it begs the question, do we really fully die when the medical doctors pronounce us as dead? No? I think it is because I give you this a hint this morning. Typically we think that once the heart stops beating, we think that's the end. And then something happens to this soul, the entity, and we wait for Gita part, shaving Gita part, and Shraddh Karma Sanskar. We wait for that. We think that that's the next significant milestone. And we think that when this soul leaves the body, this something that we call the Atma, leaves the body, that's it, it lingers around until the farewell, which is the Gita part and Shraddh. Well, that's a very simple understanding, and that's a good understanding. But it was only recently when I was exploring the chakras of the body, when I understood that Bhagavan Shiva, this body and the seven chakras of the body mirrors the chakras of the Shiva Lingam, which mirrors the atom, which mirrors the universe. When you understand the way the body works and the energy centers are awakened, when the medical doctors pronounce us as dead, D-E-D, dead. That's how you spell it? That's past tense, right? Jai Bhagwan. No students correcting me this morning. As D-E-A-D, before somebody says Pandit can't spell. When the doctors pronounce me as dead, it is not the end. At least it is not the physical end at that point. You see, we should ask, is it coincidental how many days after we died that the Shraddh Sanskar is performed? How many days after the cremation or the burial? How many days after is the Gita part and the Shraddh? Huh? Some say 12 days to 13 days. It's all based on customs as well. Based on your traditions, some would say 12 days, 13 days. But our typical Trini or the West Indian culture, we have been taught it's 13 days. Shaving ceremony. How many days is the shaving? 10 days. Some say 10, 11 days. Well, whether you think it's 10 days for shaving, whether you think it's 13 days for Shraddh, it really doesn't matter. It is your custom. I keep reminding you, based on which village you came from in India, the customs, the language would change accordingly. And you say, Baba, which one is right and which one is wrong? None is wrong. It is just based on customs. How many Saptarishis there were? Seven. Sapta means seven, right? So there were seven rishis. And based on the seven rishis, at least seven root systems, ways of, methods of worship. It started with the seven rishis. After the Adi Yoga, Bhagwan Shiva schooled the Sapta rishis in the yogic traditions. They all had their unique system. And therefore you would see the South Indian style of worship, a puja, You would say, Panditji, those people are doing something very different. Are they wrong? No, they're not wrong. It is just a handed down system based on the seven rishis. And therefore, let's take the standard today as 13 days for Shraddh. Why 13 days? Why is it that we wait for 13 days after the cremation or the burial of the body that we wait for the final send-off? Well, do you know that we can die in one of three ways? We can die by what would say natural degradation. We get old and we die. Medically, they would say, okay, maybe heart attack, maybe hypertension, high cholesterol, aneurysm, something. But when that person reaches to the ripe old age and that person dies, we say it is a natural degradation of the person's pranic energy. And I'm introducing a new term this morning, pranic. Pranic energy, it is the movement of the energy among the chakras of the body. So when a person reaches a nice ripe old age, what is old? What is old, Mama? You know, when I was 17 and 18, I thought people who were in their 20s were old. And when I got to my 20s, I thought 30s, wow. Now that I'm in my 40s, I'm thinking, wow, maybe 100 seems to be old now. Because I'm approaching, I'm measuring. So I'm afraid to also say what is old, Geet. So old age is really relative. The body naturally decays. The body goes through a natural metamorphosis. It is a change that occurs with the body. My hair didn't recede because I shave it. My hair receded because the body is going through a natural degradation. And therefore, we should understand that it is not just the physical body that degrades with time, the pranic energy also changes with time. There is something called solar cycles. When I spoke on Makar Sankranti, I shared with you that there is a concept that is known as a solar cycle. And the solar cycle, there are a certain number of cycles, I believe, I stand corrected, it's either 8 or 9. Solar cycles that takes the person's pranic energy, because the body's energy, the pran, the energy within his body, follows the pattern of the sun. And when the sun reaches 8 or 9 cycles or solar cycles, that is when we say that the body or the pranic energy of the body becomes degraded to the point of ready for departure. So that's the first type of death. It is when we reach that age, and I'm not going to define it, that age, that we say naturally that person has died of old age. Let's keep the language simple this morning. The second way that we can die, it is when the body becomes broken. Baba, what do you mean by broken? Well, have you heard about accidents where young children, young boys, young girls, men and women in their prime of their life, they're snuffed out like a thief in the night and death comes? It means when the body is no longer able to support life. And it comes in accident. It comes in disease. It comes, some would say, it comes with a broken heart also, Baba. Well, it means that when the body, even in the midst of its prime life, and the pranic energy is still strong, the chakras of the body are operating at its fullest based on your investment in your chakras. When you're a very active person and something happens in a jiffy, we say in Trinidad, we die. The pranic energy was not ready to release that body. Because the pranic energy got accustomed to enjoying life as a human being. And that's the second way that we can die. First it is old age. Second it is by broken body. Let's call it broken body. Meaning the body just boop and we're gone. And the pranic energy is now, it has a choice. What do I do? And the third way we can die, it is by choice. And I'm not talking about suicide. By choice, I mean the frequency of our chakras can resonate so high. When the seven chakras of the body resonates so high, the frequency is so high, the energy, if a conscious effort is made to hold on to that energy, people who go into what is called Mahasamadhi, they drop the physical body. This is not storybook I'm telling you, devotees. I'm telling you science, as narrated, as documented from our scripture. We can die by choice, where you can go into a state of high ecstasy. Remember the Sahasra chakra? When all the chakras are so energized and vibrating to a high frequency, that pranic energy can, not by choice, but based on the frequency, the body itself will not be able to tolerate that frequency of the energy that it leaves the body. And scientifically, you will be pronounced as D-E-A-D. You're dead. So there are three simple ways we can define as methods of how an individual can die. But we should ask the question this morning. What is it, the strength of this pranic force? It makes a difference on how we die. So let's put Mahasamadhi aside for now. Because most of us, we die either by old age or we die by broken bodies. And therefore, when the body reaches a particular age that we say old age, the pranic energy, when that person dies, that energy goes very easily. The body has, or the pranic energy would have become less attached to the physical body. But when we die of a broken body, that pranic energy that leaves the body, it doesn't all leave at the same time. I want you to understand this morning. And that is why we say we die in stages. There is something called Panch Vayu. Please repeat it. Panch Vayu. What does Panch mean? Five. Vayu means? Huh? Wind. Well, that's one definition of Vayu. We say Hanuman Baba is Vayu Putra and he's the son of the wind god. But Vayu in the Sanskrit language, the root syllable Va means that which moves. And Vayu means that energy, the Pancha Vayu, it is that energy that causes all the functions of the body to operate smoothly. So the Panch Vayu, and I want you to repeat them for me this morning. The first it is called Pran.
Pran.
The second it is called Apan.
Apan.
The third it is Udhan.
Udhan.
The fourth is Saman.
Saman.
And the fifth is Vyan.
Vyan.
I'll repeat it again. Pran.
Pran.
Apan.
Apan.
Udhan.
Udhan.
Saman.
Saman.
And Vyan.
Vyan.
And I will not go into the details of each one, but I want to let you know that when a person dies, if our chakras are not awakened at the highest level, do you know that when the pranic energy leaves the body, you would have heard this before, that the energy chooses one of the main points of entry to leave the body. Leaves through the mouth, or the nostrils, the eyes, the ears, the genitalia, the anal canal, some part based on how we live the life. That's what we were told. But it is not just the points of opening, it is based on the chakras. The chakras determine, based on how energized the chakras are, it determines which port of exit the life or that pranic energy leaves the body. And it can also leave not only from one, because if all seven are awakened, you can choose. That soul, that pranic energy, that individual becomes so highly developed that you can choose where that pranic energy leaves from. But for the ordinary person, Jayanti, where are you? When in India, I'm not sure if Trinidad this is a custom, but when someone dies in India, one of the traditions, do you know what they do? They take the two toes, the big toe, and they, what they do? Oh, you know what they do? Oh, me a customer death, so I don't know. So they take the two big toes and they tie it together. Why? Anyone? There's no wrong answer. They don't want the man to walk. That's a good one. But do you know that that's not funny? It sounds funny, but when a person dies, especially when the body is broken, that pranic energy is so unaccustomed to living in a life of detachment, because the energy is so strongly attached to that body, that energy wants to go back. And the reason for tying the two big toes together, it is because at that stage, That pranic energy wants to go back into that body. It tries very, very hard because it's unaccustomed to that state of detachment from the body. And by tying the two big toes together, what you're doing is you're closing the Muladhara Chakra. Closing the two big toes, putting them together, it allows, remember the Muladhara Chakra? The Muladhara Chakra is the chakra between the anal canal and the genitalia. And when you put the two big toes together, you're actually closing that chakra, and it prevents that soul or that pranic energy from re-entering that body. Why? So maybe it is because they don't want the man to get up and walk. Eh? You know, all of us, when a loved one dies, don't we feel sad? Don't we miss that person? Can you think about it? I am afraid to think about losing a loved one who is very close to me. Because I don't know how I will respond. And therefore, I'm sure many of you will think the same way. But if you have experienced a loss of a friend, a wife, a husband, a mother, a father, a brother, a sister, or a parent, a child, if you've experienced the loss of a loved one, isn't it normal that immediately after death, because we are denying death has occurred, what do? God, bring back this person to life. Please, I wish I could do anything so that this person will come back to life. Can you imagine on the day of the funeral, the person decided to get up? What do you do? Run, right? The emotions speak out and say, I wish that that person didn't die. The emotions go through a state of denial. But the pranic energy, none of us want the dead person to get up and come back and talk to you. Say, boy, it wasn't my time, I come back. Let me go eat some pizza, no? No. Because we want, not that we happy that the person is dead, it is because the mind, your mind is now trying to get accustomed to this process that is called death. Death is not a door shut and then it goes. And therefore, when that person dies and you tie the two toes together, it prevents that pranic energy from coming back. But do you know that children between the time of infant and the time of 8 years old, something about the energy system cannot affect children? So when a person dies and that energy, that pranic energy is looking to do something between the time of medical death and the time of Shraddh, that pranic energy is looking for something. And if after the Shraddh Karma Sanskar is performed and that soul doesn't go, get send off, or let's say the Shraddh Karma or the final send off is not done or not done properly, what happens to that pranic energy? It stays here. It remains lingering. And children from the age of birth to the age of 8 are not affected by that pranic energy. Good news, isn't it? But there's an interesting phenomenon. Based on the chakra energy of the typical adolescent, you know who an adolescent is? The child who is now moving away from that stage of life into puberty and adolescent, where the hormones start hijacking you and you start getting rebellious and you start trying to define your identity and there's so much pressure around. I'm not saying anything wrong. I'm saying that's a natural phenomenon. Children, we all went through that. Children, some of you are now going through that. Scientifically, it is proven and it is also documented in the Mahabharata that those at that age bandwidth, anytime there are souls or pranic energy that did not get the final send-off and remains lingering, that age, sometimes you say, what is going on with the children at this age? Because some of them get guidance and they realign, but some of them don't realign and they become astray. And I always thought that was a societal thing. I always thought that was lack of guidance. But only recently, I found out, having read and gotten deeper into this concept of the pranic energy leaving, that pranic energy that lingers affects adolescent more than any others. So children between the age of birth and 8, the energy does not affect you. But during the ages of adolescent, that period, unless we invest in our children, and that's a very important, we must invest in our children, because there is pranic energy out there that is looking to influence. And therefore, we should ask, why is it that we wait for the 13 days to perform the Shraddh Karma Sanskar? Why do we perform the Gita part? Why do we perform that final Anteshti Karma Sanskar. It is because at that time, we're told according to the Mahabharata, in 11 days, that's when death concludes. In 11 days, after the medical doctor pronounces dead, after 11 days, the fifth of the Panch Vayu would leave the body. They all don't leave at the same time. First, the first one to leave, which is the first Pran Vayu to leave? It is the fire. The body starts getting cooled. That's the first of the Panch Vayu to leave. But all the other four don't leave at the same time. The last one is Vyana. Vyana Vayu. And the Vyana Vayu, it is the energy that moves within the body because of the element that is called water. Do you know that the body is how much percent water? 75% water. And therefore, the last of that energy to leave the body, it is the Vyana Vayu. And that typically happens around day 11. And therefore, immediately, it is fire. Pran, then Udhan, then Saman, then what is the other one? Apan. And then fifth, it is Vyana, Vyanu. Each one has a specific function. And I don't want to go into it this morning, but I'll give you a little suggestion, a little hint. Do you know that speech, it is? Speech, it is Apan. Anything that causes the body to physically let out. When we go to the toilet, that is Apan. But any energy, we think sometimes it is only urinating and defecating, is allowing the energy to leave this body. But when we speak and the vocal cords operate, there are many other energies or many other functions that follow the pattern of Apan. Pran means we intake. We take the breath. But it's not only that. See, the eye is also intake. Isn't that so? The air is also intake. And therefore, pran is not only that which we inhale. Pran is anything, the energy that allows your body to experience the world. Apan, to give out. And like this, without going into the detail, the last, it is Vyanu. And Vyanu, that energy, it is the energy of water within the body that connects all the other energies by flowing through what we call blood. And on the 11th day, that's when you really die. You totally die. The body literally totally dies after 11 days. And you would say, Pandiji, why is it that the Muslims, as soon as somebody dies, they want to burn the body or they want to bury? That's a good thing. Why is it that we, in Sanatana Dharma, we say, don't wait too long, don't keep the body too long. Burn the body, yeah? Dispose of the body, whether it's burial or cremation. But our way of life says, while there are many options for disposing of the body, there is one option that is best or most recommended. And that option, it is cremation. And I'll tell you why after this very beautiful chant.
Bhajumani Radhe Govinda. Bhajuman Radhe 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 Govinda.
Prem se bolo Shri Vrindavan Bihari Lal ki.
Bhajuman Radhe Govinda.
Bhajuman Radhe Govinda.
Bhajuman Radhe Govinda. Bhajuman Radhe 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 Govinda.
Bhajuman Radhe 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 Govinda.
Bhajuman Krishna Kanhaiya.
Bhajuman Krishna Kanhaiya.
Bhajuman Krishna 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 Kanhaiya.
Bhajumana Krishna 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 Kanhaiya.
Bhaj Rajman Shiva Shankar
Rajman Shiva Shankar
Rajman Shiva 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 Shankar
Rajman Shiva 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 Shiva
Rajman Sai Baba Bolo
Rajman Sai Baba
Rajman Sai 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 Baba
Rajman Sai 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 Baba
Rajman Rani Guru Radhe
Rajman Radhe Govinda
Rajman Radhe 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 Govinda
Rajman Radhe 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 Govinda
Rajman Radhe 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 Govinda
Rajman Radhe Radhe
Rajman Krishna Kanhaiya
Rajman Krishna Kanhaiya
Rajman Krishna 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 Kanhaiya
Rajman Krishna 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 Kanhaiya
Rajman Shiva Shankar
Rajman Shiva
Rajman Shiva 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 Shankar
Rajman Shiva 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 Shankar
Rajman Sai Baba
Rajman Sai Baba
Rajman Sai 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 Hare
Rajman Sai
Rajman Radhe Govinda Rajman Radhe Govinda Rajman Radhe Govinda
Rajman Radhe 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 Govinda Prem se bolo Shri Vrindavan Vihari Lal ki There is something called Runanu Bandhu. What is it called? I don't know. It's called Runanu Bandhu. It means when death comes, when the doctors medically pronounce us as dead, one of the healthiest things that we can do it is to dispose of that body. Don't keep the body for long. And you would say, Paniji, if it takes 11 days, why don't we just keep for 11 days and maybe something will happen? No. When a person dies, let them go. Emotionally, it's difficult. I'm not speaking about an emotional. It is not about forgetting the person. That is not what I'm saying. Emotionally, we should treasure those moments. We don't forget our loved ones. We treasure our loved ones. But when death comes, we must let the dead go. And therefore, runanu bandhu means breaking the physical attachment. And that's why we are encouraged that even before the 11 days, whether it's day one, day two, day three, as soon as you can, allow the body to be disposed. Because do you notice, as I conclude this morning, have you ever noticed that when you go to a funeral at the home, a lot of crying, isn't it? A lot of emotions that are outpouring. You go to the cremation ground and there are still, as the fire is lit, there's so much crying. But when the body is burnt, look, do you see individuals still expressing the same amount of emotions or is it quietened a bit? You know what happened? Runanu Bandhu. Because the intellect, while the emotions are high, the intellect is now processing death has really occurred. Because when the body is cremated, the mind, the human beings who are left behind, processes it and allows the send-off of that body. That is the significance of ensuring that the body is disposed of earlier. Burial is okay, but cremation gives the person, the loved ones who are left behind, the ability to break that bond. Because if you are holding on to that body for too long, remember, it is not just the physical body, it is the pranic energy that is causing the attachment. And when we break that, we release that bondage, runanu bandhu, we are allowing the soul, that pranic energy or the soul, to go, to continue on its journey. But secondly, at a physical level, why do we sprinkle the ashes in the water? Because we're saying now, we're allowing the physical remains of that runanu bandhu to be as far dispersed as possible to allow it to go back into creation. It does not, is not so much for the person who has died, but it allows the breaking of the bondage between the loved ones who are left behind and the attachment to that entity that once occupied the body that we would have called ma or pa. See? And therefore, today, this katha is a very different katha this morning. I'm sure you would agree. It is a topic about death that many of us, we shy away from. But you see, when we understand death, when we understand death, life becomes more beautiful. And therefore, when we understand when death occurs, it is not just one shot closed door. It takes time. It starts as early as 24 minutes to 58 minutes after the person dies for the first energy to go. And then up to 11 days for the fifth and the final vayu of the panch vayu to leave that body. Prem se bolo Sri Vrindavan Bihari Lal ki. Are Vrindavan Bihari Lal ki. I will not do death anymore. I'm not getting jai jai cars as I should. Prem se bolo Sri Vrindavan Bihari Lal ki.